I guarantee him before, right? That's where we left off yesterday. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. I thought we had two lessons, number five, and then we're going to talk about, we're going to talk about the next thing. I made the decision that because today is really the end of what we would do for chapter five, I don't think you guys want to come back and break and take a test. So we only have to do like three sections of chapter six. I'm just going to combine the end of five with six. And then the nice thing about that is the end of five hasn't been as pleasant, right? The beginning of six is pretty easy, right? So that way it kind of combines something easier with something a little more difficult to balance it out for this, right? Okay. All right. Hopefully. All right. Have a whole extra week to practice it, though. That's what you would do, right? Okay. Calculus every day. All right. We use a differential equation with specified initial condition to find y. All right. This actually is a really good lead up to what we do in chapter six. We do a lot of this. So this is separation of variables. We've talked about this before. That means the first thing we need to do is move the dx to the other side. So dy equals 1/4 plus x squared dx. Maybe not in this context, but you're gonna see this process on the AP test on the free response. Okay, and this is the one that's worth a whole bunch of points on the free response. Okay, and like most parts of the free response are worth like 3 points. The one that does this piece is worth 5. Okay, or 6. Sometimes I've seen 7. Ridiculous. But you gotta be able to do this. Okay. Alright. Typically though it isn't with an arctan or a skin in just this context. Alright, what's the integration of dy? I could have probably, in fact, I should have, and I will go back. If we want to see our true day, right, which I'm sure you can do in your head, but we would probably rather see that written as 2 squared. Okay? So this is our a, that's our u. If you need to write them under there, if that helps, you can do that. Okay. A is always the number, your u is always the variable. Yes, but remember we can turn anything into a square number. So if it was a 3 there, you throw a square root over the top, and it's a square root. Okay, does that make sense? So everything is a square number. They do, but remember we want to, this would be the official A, right? So whatever is an A is the square root. Okay, sound good? Okay, so. We have our sine, our secant, or our tangent. Our tangent. Okay, so we have 1 over a. What's your a? 2. Our tangent of u over a. What's your u value? X over the a is 2 plus c. Alright. Whenever you have, and even it says it here and it gives it to you there, they gave you an initial condition. Always have to use it. Remember I told you, in AP Calc, on the free response question, they don't give you extra information to throw you off. You have to use every piece of information. Okay? You have it, you put it somewhere wrong. Alright, so I'm going to plug this in. The goal is to solve for C. Okay, so we're getting a specific equation for that point rather than just a general equation where we don't really know what C to tip that end back to C. So what's going to go in for the y value? Y goes in. Okay. And then for the x is going to be what? 2. Alright, we're going to have to go to unit circle, right? What is 2 over 2 really be? One, I'm not going to rewrite that just yet. We have to figure out the radian measure for arctangent of 1. So remember, arctangent is valid in 1 and 4. Where is it going to be positive? Quadrant 1, okay. And again, we go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That's all we really need in a unit circle. Right here is where it would be sine over cosine, and it's going to reduce to 1. So what's my radian measure right there? Pi over 4. Let's see. We have 1/2 times pi over 2. Pi over over 8, okay? I'm going to do a couple things at the same time. So I just said that was pi over 8. I'm still plus c. Eventually, am I going to have to take that pi over 8 to the other side? Don't I need a common denominator of 8? Can't I make that e pi over 8? What are we going to do with pi over 8 to get to the other side? Subtract this, so c is... Then officially we go back here to the line where we have the plus c, plug the 7 pi over 8 in for the plus c. So our final answer for that specified initial condition is 1 half arctangent of x over 2 plus 7 pi over 8 in plus 1 half. You may want to write yourself a little note. When you see these words here, that means find the plus c. Fancy words for saying find the plus c. Value of c. Okay? Yes? Because I multiplied 2 times 4 and I got 8. And then in order for me to combine this one with the pi, I had to have a common denominator. Got it. Okay. I could I have written it as pi minus pi over 8? Is that still a good answer? Looks ugly, but it's still a good answer. Still a correct answer. Okay. And if it was a free response question, they could mark it off. Okay. But it's not in our rules of the five fractions. Okay. So this again, totally change. Different type of question. Now we're going to find the area of the region bounded by the graph of f of x, the x-axis, and the following lines. Okay? So basically what they're saying is we're integrating this, and these are your limits. Okay? And the limits will be before. But we can handle it. Alright, so I'm going to go from 3 halves to 9 over 4. That's 1 over the square root of 3x. Sure, because maybe I'm doing it wrong. I don't know. Last time I checked, that was what happened, right? Alright. 9 times over out of 10, they're in order. Okay? But there is that 10th time when they're not in order. So you do want to make sure you check. Okay? So I'm glad we're trying to make sure we're doing it right. That's good. Alright. This is going to be the worst completing the square we've seen. Okay? But I promise when you see what happens when we complete the square, you're going to understand these limits a little bit better. Okay? Alright, so we're going to try to jam it into either arc sine, arc secant, or arc tangent. Okay? We learned yesterday about this completing the square business, so that's what we're going to see. I'm going to complete the square on this chunk in here. Okay? When I write this over here, I'm going to do two things. I'm going to reverse the order, and I'm going to factor out the negative. Okay, so I'm taking the negative out. Taking out a big negative. So I'm going to write x squared minus 3x. Then I know I have to add something and subtract something that are really the same number, right? So that way we're adding zero. Alright, I'm going to set up my cheating factor in B. So I got something, x something squared, and it's probably going to be minus something. It's going to be whatever's in that last line there. Okay. I pulled out this negative right here, so we reversed both of those signs. That is, when I do complete the square, I don't want to be coefficient. Basically, what I did was I pre-divided by my new coefficient. That's what really we're doing. I call the factor in the opposite side. Alright, what are we supposed to do with the middle term? Divide by 2, alright? Negative 3 halves. Check it out. Isn't that this bottom number right here? Okay. Alright, what am I now supposed to do with it to complete the square? Square it. What do we get? Hey, look at the top number. There it is. format that we want for the arctangent, arcsine, arcsecant. Okay? This piece now is equivalent to under here, so we're going to sub it in for that. Supplement on it.